Today we're going to be talking about creeks. The creek behind me is the Arroyo Burro Creek. Now, when taking a look at the creek, you can notice that there are many different types of plants. Some are native and some are non-native.
Native plants are plants that have always originated in their ecosystem. Non-native species are sometimes called invasive species and are species that are not indigenous to an area and can cause environmental harm.
Okay. In Santa Barbara, we have some non-native species that are living and growing in our local creeks and causing problems. One species is called the giant reed, which is very fast growing. This plant originated in the Mediterranean and loves the weather in Santa Barbara. The plant loves drinking up all the water along the creek, and due to this, it is taking up space along the bank that belongs to native species. The giant reed is also problematic because it is very dry and serves as a flood and fire hazard. This plant right next to me is a giant reed, and as you can see, it is very dry and serves as a fire and flood hazard.
This is bamboo. It is also an invasive species.
The following species are eucalyptus trees. These very big trees use a lot of water and have very brittle wood. These trees serve as fire hazards due to them being highly flammable. The roots of these trees are also taking up all the nutrients for native species, causing them to have difficulties surviving.
Another species is Cape Ivy. Cape Ivy is a rapidly growing and dense plant. This species originated in South Africa, where the plant was found in stream banks. When the plant popped up in Santa Barbara, the vines of the ivy started taking over riverbanks and were not able to be controlled. The roots of these plants are very shallow and are causing issues, such as erosion and flooding.
Go. All in all, non-native species need to go. They have been having some negative effects on our creeks and rivers. Creeks serve a very important purpose in our community.
Creeks are responsible for the transportation of water from our mountains to our oceans. Within the water traveling through our creeks, organisms are provided with a water source. The vegetation around the creeks serves as a natural filter to purify the water before it enters our ocean. The health of our creeks determines the health of the ecosystem surrounding it. Also, the non-native species are impacting the biodiversity of the creek.
When these non-native species start taking over our creeks, they are pushing out native species who have a very important job in our creek ecosystem.
The question is, how did these non-native species end up in our creeks? The answer has to do with our human activities. As humans, we are unintentionally transporting these seeds to new locations, and due to this, this is how a plant from South Africa can end up in Santa Barbara. Humans are causing this issue, and we need to fix it.
Our solution is to use sheep.
The organization Kuyama Lamb has been used to get rid of the highly flammable vegetation and invasive species at Gaviota Coast, San Marcos Preserve, Quail Ridge, Ealings Park, and the Channel Islands. Our idea is for the organization to move from land to our creeks. The mission of Kuyama Lamb is to harness the power of grazing to restore native ecologies. They're using sheep to get rid of vegetation. It is a natural solution instead of using equipment that will damage the ecosystem.
When the sheep are grazing, their safety is very important. They are kept very safe with fencing and protected by Great Pyrenees during the day and at night. The sheep provide these ecosystems with many benefits. First, they are able to clear out the vegetation. Secondly, they are stomping on the ground when they graze, helping the plants decompose and go back into the soil to be broken down. Finally, the sheep leave behind fertilizer for the soil.
Once sheep clear out the vegetation, it allows for native seeds to be dispersed and restore the natural biodiversity of the ecosystem. With our proposed idea, we hope that this could help restore our creeks back to having only native species.
There are still some limitations with our proposed idea. One issue is that the sheep will be eating all the plants in the creek, including the native species that we want to keep. The second problem is that environmentalists are going to have to figure out what native species to plant in the creeks that were originally there. They're going to make sure that they maintain the biodiversity of our creeks and have a balance of different species of plants. The final problem is that the whole process is going to take some time energy and resources to have our creek back to the original state. Cuyama Lamb acquires a form of funding from the city, and an amount of funding determines the extent of their services.